Let's talk about lipoproteins. Lipoproteins, as you can see here, are transport vehicles for lipids in both the blood and the lymph. The lipids that are being transported, triglycerides and cholesterol, do not mix with the watery blood and lymph, so they need a special carrier or transporter, which are going to be lipoproteins. These lipoproteins are synthesized in the body, and they're composed of triglycerides and cholesterol, phospholipids, and protein. The triglycerides and cholesterol are the lipids that are needing to be transported to cells, and the phospholipids and protein are part of the structure of the lipoprotein. So let's take a look at what a lipoprotein looks like here. Here's a lipoprotein, and if we were to cut and slice inside this lipoprotein, what we would find inside are the lipids, triglycerides, and cholesterol, which don't want to mix with the watery blood and the watery lymph. Then we have phospholipids, which is another type of lipid, but remember, these are unique in that they have a hydrophilic head, a water-loving head, and a fat-loving tail. So the fat-loving tail will be tucked into the middle and be in contact with the cholesterol and triglycerides, and then the water-loving head that contains the phosphate group will be on the outside in contact with the watery blood and the watery lymph. The proteins that you find here, remember, protein doesn't need a special carrier. Protein is able to mix with water just fine, so it can travel around in the blood by itself, but this protein is helping to stabilize the structure, and it also identifies receptors on cell membranes to help navigate the lipoprotein, so the lipoprotein knows where it's going and knows where to deliver its special package, the triglycerides and the cholesterol that are inside. The lipoproteins that I want you to know about for this course are going to be chylomicrons, LDL, and HDL. There also is VLDL, but we're going to focus on LDL and HDL because they play major roles in heart health and are the focus of most lipid recommendations. So right here, you can LDL and HDL are featured. I'll go back to chylomicrons here in just a minute, but you can see that all four components of the lipoprotein, we just talked about it, are a part of these lipoproteins. So they both contain protein, cholesterol, phospholipids, and triglyceride, but you can see just different proportions. In general, the LDL are going to be larger, they're going to be lighter because they are going to be richer in lipids, and the HDLs are going to be smaller, denser, and packaged with more protein, hence high density and low density. These two are also going to differ in the way that they carry lipids. So LDLs carry triglycerides and cholesterol to the tissues. An HDL is a scavenger and can scavenge excess cholesterol and other lipids from the tissues to the liver for disposal. To remember these, the HDL, you can think of it as a more helpful lipoprotein. It's scavenging that cholesterol we might not need in cells and taking it away. HDL can actually even, because of its role it plays, even help reverse heart disease. Where LDL being less helpful, still important, cells we know absolutely need cholesterol. Cholesterol is a vital component to cellular health. But when LDL becomes less helpful is when the proteins on the surface can become oxidized and can do damage to arterial walls, which leads to a series of reactions that causes plaque buildup or atherosclerosis. And LDLs carry lipids that may trigger inflammation that also contributes to heart disease. So in general, high LDL levels are thought to have a negative impact on heart health. High HDLs are thought to have a positive impact. And if we were to have the breakdown of chylomicrons here. Chylomicrons are synthesized in intestinal cells after eating, digesting, and absorbing triglycerides. So they're mainly triglycerides. So we would see a big component of the chylomicron being triglycerides. So we'll fill in your lecture outline on that. These chylomicrons are made in intestinal cells. Again, they're made after eating dietary fat. That fat has been digested, it has been absorbed into intestinal cells, and that fat needs a special carrier to get around in the watery lymph and blood. So going to be composed of protein and the three type of lipids that we just looked at, but it's going to have the largest component of triglycerides since this is the main lipid in our food. And this chylomicron will carry triglycerides from intestinal cells to cells all over the body. The low-density lipoproteins are going to be made in the liver. So we don't get low-density lipoproteins in foods. This is something that is synthesized in the body. It's also going to be composed of protein and lipids. The main component is going to be cholesterol, which is what it primarily delivers to cells. So going to carry triglycerides and cholesterol from the liver to body cells. And as I mentioned, it can have a negative impact on heart disease risk. And then the high-density lipoproteins, the more helpful lipoproteins, again, these are synthesized in the body, at the liver. They're not going to be found in foods. High density, so again, going to contain all four components, proteins and lipids, but the predominant substance is going to be protein. These guys carry cholesterol from cells to the liver for disposal, so actually can remove cholesterol from plaque, and which is why it has a positive impact on heart health.